So, let us get started. We have completed the fundamental concepts required for this course. In particular, we discussed the Reynolds transport theorem, which relates the laws of physics to the conservation equations. Now, we are ready to derive the conservation equations using the Reynolds transport theorem, and that is what is indicated by these arrow marks, which start from the Reynolds transport theorem and goes to the total mass balance, goes to the linear momentum balance, goes to energy balance, and goes to the species mass balance. So, we start with the laws of physics, use Reynolds transport theorem, and derive these conservation equations, and within each of these conservation equations, we derive the integral balance and the differential balance. So, if you look at the course overview, we have integral and differential balance and a total mass balance. Similarly, we have integral and differential balance for linear momentum balance. Similarly, integral and differential balance here for energy balance, and similarly for species balance. Okay. Of course, we are going to take several lectures to discuss all this and derive all this, but we are into derivation of these conservation equations. Okay. So, just an introduction to the conservation equations as such. So, as we have seen in the last slide, we are going to discuss and derive the balance of total mass, linear momentum, energy, and then species mass. When we say mass, we clearly distinguish as total mass and the species mass. Species mass comes much later in the course. So, until then, mass and total mass are equivalent. Okay. And we said we are going to discuss both the macroscopic balance, also called as integral balance, and the microscopic balance or the differential balance. So, we are going to derive conservation equations which state the balance of total mass, linear momentum, energy, species mass, both in the macroscopic form and the microscopic form. Alternate names are integral and differential. Macroscopic tells you it is over the entire equipment, and the form of the equation what you get is integral, that is why it is integral balance. Microscopic balance is a small region inside the equipment, and the equation what you get is differential equation, that is why differential balance over differential element. Okay. So, small introduction about macroscopic balance and the microscopic balance before we start actually deriving the conservation equations. Okay. So, as I told you, macroscopic balances are balances written over the entire equipment, and few equipments are shown here. For example, you have a pipe here, and the dashed red boundary indicates the control volume. The control volume now surrounds the entire pipe, and it takes into account what is the fluid flowing in and then the fluid flowing out. Similarly, for the pump, a boundary is drawn around the pump, and then you account for what is flowing in, flowing out. In addition to that, you also supply some power to the pump, so that the fluid is pumped. Okay. Of course, the power is not a material stream. What is shown are the fluid entering and fluid leaving streams. In addition to that, power is also supplied in terms of, let us say, work interaction with the surroundings. And then what is shown here is heat exchanger. Once again, the boundary is drawn around the entire heat exchanger, and streams entering the heat exchanger and leaving the heat exchanger cross the boundary. So, we do a macroscopic balance or integral balance around the heat exchanger, accounting for streams, accounting for energy which is carried by the streams into and out of the control volume. Similarly, here for the absorber, an absorption column, where again we draw a control volume over the entire equipment or the entire absorber, and account for the material which is brought in, brought out, and then similarly taken in and taken out. And similarly for the reactor, we have the boundary drawn over the entire reactor, and we account for the components which are entering the reactor and leaving the reactor. In all these cases, we do not focus on what is inside the equipment. The boundary is drawn around entire equipment. So, let us look at that. So, balance of an entire equipment, that is, we have seen several examples of that. We account for change to, what are the changes we account for? Introduction and removal through the entering and leaving streams. That is very obvious from all these figures, that whatever a material which is brought in, brought out, that is accounted for. Introduction, removal through the entering and leaving streams. Not alone material, it could be energy as well. When you do energy balance, we account for energy as well. So, when I say account for change due to introduction, removal through entering and leaving streams, it accounts for total mass, it could be species mass, it could be momentum, it could be energy. A flowing stream contains any of these. So, depending on the balance we do, we account for any of these properties. Now, other than that, other than the property which is being brought in and brought taken out by the streams, you have other inputs to the control volume in the surroundings. What are they? External forces. For example, this pipe has to be supported, some force is required, what is that force? And then, as I told you some time back, you will have to supply work to this. So, work input, in some places there could be heat input, heat output, heat exchange, the surroundings, let us say. So, all those are interaction with the surroundings, inputs and outputs from the surroundings. And other than that, there could be sources in the control volume itself. For example, there could be a source of heat, you could have a small heating element, or a reaction is a source of a component. It is not a source of total mass, but source of component. So, all these are accounted when we do a macroscopic balance. Whatever carried by the entering and leaving streams, and then other interactions with the surroundings in terms of forces, heat, work, and then other sources in the control volume in terms of heat or reaction. We focus the based on what we have discussed, should be obvious that we focus on global characteristics, gross behavior. We do not look at the local behavior, we look at the global characteristics and gross behavior of the equipment or the control volume. So, what are the global characteristics? For example, we are interested in the mass flow, we may find out the unknowns would be finding out mass flow, induced force, energy change. For example, we may find out what is the power to be supplied here, and then what is the mass flow entering, leaving, that could be our unknowns. And then similarly, what is the induced force? So, those are the unknowns which you will solve for when you do a macroscopic balance. And then attention is not focused on the details like velocity, temperature, concentration profiles. We do not look at the velocity profile in the pipe, or the, let us say, the temperature profile in the heat exchanger, or the concentration profile in the absorber. So, we do not focus attention on the profiles, and other way of putting that is, we do not require details on these profiles for this kind of analysis. And because we write a macroscopic balance, when you simplify, what you get is a algebraic equation if it is a steady state process. If it is a transient process, you get an ordinary differential equation. The reason is, we do not consider the spatial variation. So, all the spatial coordinates are gone. The only independent variable could be time if it is a transient process. If that is also the steady state process, time is also not an independent variable. So, it will result in a simple algebraic expression. Okay? That is the advantage of doing a macroscopic balance, so that it becomes easy to solve. Okay? Algebraic equations or even ordinary differential equations are easy to solve. So, it becomes fast, simple and very practically useful method. And so, for gives answers that are sufficiently accurate for most engineering purposes. If you are looking at an engineering level of accuracy, then you get answers which are sufficiently accurate. Okay? So, to summarize the macroscopic balance, we do balance over the entire equipment, then account for changes because of the streams, and interaction with surroundings and sources within the volume, focus on global characteristics, gross behavior in terms of mass flow, force, then energy change. We do not focus on the profiles, we result in algebraic or ordinary differential equations and a simple practical useful method of engineering accuracy. Now, let us move on to the microscopic balance, the differential balance. Now, this case of as the name indicates microscopic balance, we take control volumes are within the equipment which are very very small, and in fact at every point is considered as a control volume. Okay. Few examples are shown here, a pipe is shown here where we take a control volume which is inside the pipe and then account for changes for this small control volume and almost make it very very small, it becomes just a point. And then similarly for the case of a furnace wall is shown here, and where we have shown a control volume within the furnace wall and then we account for changes of what is happening inside this small control volume, it's a differential control volume. And similarly in this absorber a small control volume is shown and then we do balance for this small control volume. Similarly the reactor control volume is shown within the equipment and we do balance equations, conservation equations for this small control volume. Okay, let us go ahead. So, as we have seen we write balance over a small region, and if you make the region smaller and smaller it just becomes at a point in equipment. That is why in this case we are able to get more and more details, able to get profiles of velocity, temperature, etcetera. Okay. So, describe change in the small region. Okay. As we have seen this small region, we describe the changes in a small region and it can become a small point as well. Okay. And okay, because we are able to, because we are focusing on a very very small region, we will be able to get information on the velocity, pressure, temperature, concentration profiles within the equipment. So, for example, here when you write the microscopic balance and then solve, you will be able to get what is the velocity profile across the diameter. In this case, what is the temperature profile across the thickness of the wall? Here, what is the concentration profile along the length of the absorber? And similarly, here, what is the concentration of, let us say, the reactant or product along the length of the reactor? Because we write differential balances over a small region, when we solve we get information about profiles of all these variables, okay. Which means this we are getting much more detailed information compared to what we got in the macroscopic balance. Okay. And once you get detailed information we have better understanding of the process and then better design of the equipments. And okay, now space is a variable, the way in which I have seen we said we are going to get profiles, which means the spatial variable, for example, x axis, y axis, z axis, x, y, z coordinates is one variable. So, the least what you get is a ordinary differential equation, if it is a steady state process and then only one spatial variation, let us say in this pipe there is variation along the radius, it is all steady state. So, you will have an ordinary differential equation in terms of, let us say, r. Let us say in this case along the thickness of the furnace wall you are interested in finding the temperature profile. So, this axis the variation, so you have one independent variable resulting in an ordinary differential equation. So, likewise there is at least one spatial variable resulting in an ordinary differential equation. Of course, which is a more general case would be variation along different directions. Let us say in this particular case you are interested in the variation along x axis, y axis, z axis, all the three directions. Similarly, here all the r theta 0, r theta z directions, which means that you will result in partial differential equations. If time is a variable, time also adds, and then you result in a, once again of course, a partial differential equation. So, you result either in a ordinary or partial differential equations depending on the variable, but what is important is that these equations are going to be more difficult to solve. Earlier we had just either algebraic equations, or if it is unsteady state we have the ordinary differential equation with time as a variable. Now, least is a ordinary differential equation without time with only one spatial variable, otherwise many a times result in partial differential equation. So, more difficult to solve certainly. Okay. Usually what we do is we make simplifying assumptions and solve the resulting simplified equations. Okay. These two slides are to give an overview. As we derive the macroscopic and microscopic balances for the different properties, namely mass, momentum, temperature and species, you will understand these what is contained in these slides much better. Okay. This slide shows the control volumes and the experimental setups which we have come across and discussed earlier. On the left hand side is the experimental setup for flow through a pipe, and the right hand side it shows the setup for the flow through a tank. Okay. Now, what is shown here are the control volumes for integral balance and differential balance. The left hand side setup, the red dashed boundary represents the balance, the boundary for integral balance, where the control volume is drawn over the entire pipe covering through which water flows in and water flows out. Similarly, on the setup in the right side, this is the control volume and through which water flows in and through these two inlets, and water flows out through this outlet. Once again, this control volume is over the entire equipment through which there is flow in and flow out. Now, these streams carry with them the mass as such, the total mass, and then they also carry with them momentum, they carry with them energy, and then they also, if there are multiple species or let us say two species, then they also carry with them the components as such. Okay. So, when we do a integral mass balance, we account for these properties which are carried by the streams into and out of the control volume. This slide also shows the control volume for differential balance. Those are shown by this yellow color boundary, dashed boundary. In this setup of pipe, shown a control volume within the pipe, and in this second setup on the right hand side, there are different smaller control volumes possible. One control volume could be inside the tank, or I could also have a small control volume in the inlet pipes or in the outlet pipe as well. Okay. So, these are control volumes within the equipment, and we choose such control volumes for doing a differential balance, and then within for this control volume, a small control volume, we analyze the flow of total mass, momentum, energy and species mass. And because we consider these control volumes within the equipment and become smaller and smaller, that is become a point, we are able to analyze the profiles of velocity, temperature, concentration by doing a differential balance by choosing such small control volumes.